in Australia, Europe, US, or anywhere in the world, there must be very scrupulous application of the international treaties and national laws protecting migrant workers and refugees, their safety in the workplace and in the community they live. We know of too many abominable cases of ill treatment of migrant workers in Hong Kong, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, to name but a few of the more notorious ones, and some indeed in our region. Unfortunately, it has happened in Australia as well, but here has been exposed, workers have been awarded monies out to them, and prosecutions ensuing. These are all fundamental questions on migration, safe migration, protection of migrant rights, and taking stock of, to harness the potential of migration for national and global development. So brothers and sisters in Australia, brothers and sisters in government and parliament in Australia, both at the federal state and federal and state level. My sister Pauline Hanson, yes, she is my sister, in God, rethink all fears and prejudices. I'm sure you have had a good look at the record of generations of refugees and migrants in this country. And you have seen how they have contributed to the comfort, prosperity, and safety of today's Australia, and how a vast majority are loyal Australians, serving with distinction in the Defence Forces, Customs and Immigration and Police. I don't like watching on TV how Mrs. Pauline Hanson was recently cursed and chased away from some cafe somewhere in Queensland. I would have invited Mrs. Hanson in, offered her coffee, and politely engaged her in conversation. Australia needs not fear. Australia does need more people, educated people, a more inclusive and egalitarian society. Welcome the refugees fleeing wars and extreme poverty. Educate their children and youth. Give a chance to their parents. Some might be educated. Give a chance to improve on their education and experience. Others might not have education and experience relevant for the needs of Australia. Surely you can offer appropriate retraining programs that are in need in Australia that would make them more employable. Australia is better than the fable El Dorado because it's real. Real gold and fortunes were found here. And the greatest gold of all found here is freedom, dignity, the rule of law, peace and security.